the Julie Andrews Hour.
In your old restaurant with no place to go, life seems weary, dreary and slow. I try to fool myself, then I suddenly know that I'm all dressed up with no place to go. So I'll just grab my coat and get my hat.
Get your hat. Leave all worries on the doorstep.
Step.
Just direct our feet
to the sunny side of the street.
Can be so sweet on the sunny side of the street.
I used to walk
in the shade
with my blues
on the rain,
but now I'm not afraid. This rover crossed over. I'm in heaven. I'm in heaven. And my heart beats so that I can hardly see.
Always get all the fun things to do on the show.
Mm-hmm.
I'd give anything to be in your place.
Oh. Okay, Alice, you got it.
Oh, thank you, Julie.
You're welcome.
Well, come on, fellas. Let's go back to our dressing room. Rich Little.
When Rich gave me a chance to sing with almost anybody I liked.
There are plenty more, Julie, and the thing is, they don't have to be singers.
Okay, let's have a go.
Sing, sing, sing a little song with me. Although I never know just who you'll be.
Oh, we could sing in perfect harmony if we begin with Brother Bing. A mule is an animal with long and funny ears. He kicks up at anything he hears.
His back is brawny and his brain is weak.
Oh, he's just plain stupid, you know, with a stubborn streak.
And by the way, if you hate to go to school,
you may grow up to be a mule. Or would you rather sing on a star? Carry moonbeams home in a jar.
You're a great singer, but I've got a little tip for you that'll help your career and make you a big star.
Oh, really, George? What's that?
Well, first, I want you to sing a little of the song, I think you know it, I Could Have Danced All Night.
Okay.
I could have danced all night. I could have danced all night. And still have been.
Hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it, hold it.
Julie, that was nice, but the way you do it, it takes all night to sing it.
Here's how you should do it. Nelson?
In my key.
That's a nice key. I could have danced all night, I could have spread my wings, done 1,000 things I've never done before. Never know, it may be so exciting, all was my heart to fly, only know when she began to dance with me, could have danced all night, boom, finished, and that way you don't wear out your shoes.
Yeah, you got a lot of class, kid.
Listen, if you don't mind, I would like to have the last word on this.
Oh, go right ahead, Jack.
Thanks. Free. You know, and you see.
I've been accustomed to the face of Humphrey Bogart on the screen.
Accustomed to whistles night and noon, smiles, frowns, ups or downs, are second nature to me now, like breathing out or breathing in. I was serenely independent, content before we met. Surely I could always be that way again. And yet, I've grown accustomed to a look, accustomed to a voice, accustomed to her.
Special people.
They're the luckiest
one very special person.
I see, and I think I know who it is.
Who's that?
His name is Walter Brenner.
Creepers. Where'd you get those creepers?
Jeepers, creepers. Where'd you get those eyes?
Here, gosh, you get out. How'd they get so good?
We've got a most important day to set.
I'm sure that we can make a great duet. And we can sing a little love song all night long. Ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da.
Since man first looked up into the heavens, there has been a belief that the events of mankind are controlled by the stars. Each sign of the horoscope has been said to dictate the character, the personality, and even the destiny of those born under them. Well, whether we believe it or not, astrology is fun to contemplate.
Look to the stars, stars like Jupiter and Mars. Things could be fine if you follow your sign. If you follow your sign.
When the moon
is in the seventh house,
and Jupiter
aligns with Mars,
then peace.
Words spoken or written, like Abraham Lincoln.
67 years ago, our fathers brought forth on this continent a new nation conceived in liberty and
Aquarius.
The most important part of the body for Aquarians?
The
Yeah.
will you welcome Mr. John Davidson.
I promised myself to treat myself and visit a nearby town. Climbing up to the top, throw myself off in an effort to make it clear to you what it's like when you're shattered, left standing in the lurch by church where people are saying, oh, gee, that's tough. She stood him up. No point in us remaining. Might as well go home, as I did on my own, alone again. Naturally, think that only yesterday I was cheerful, bright and gay, looking forward to, wouldn't you, the room I was about to play. Without as much as a mere touch, cut me into little pieces, leaving me in doubt. Talk about God in his mercy. Who, if he really does exist, why did he desert me in my hour of need? I truly am indeed alone again, naturally.
Oh, gosh, that was awesome.
Thank you.
Oh, I've never heard anything.
singing so sad?
Oh, my goodness, why are you crying? That was just a song.
Oh, but you sang it with such conviction. Listen, I have a very nice girlfriend in Walton-on-Thames, and she'd be delighted to fly over for
Honest,
you.
I'm not lonely. It was just a song.
She's a nifty dancer, and she's a lot of fun.
Julie, I'm very happy. Look, see?
Well, maybe Sid Ceasar could set up a good gin rummy game for you.
How could I be sad when I get to sing a duet with you?
No.
And just pull yourself together. You've got a whole show to do. Pull yourself together. We're going to sing our duet in another minute.
Oh. You sure everything's going to be all right?
Yes, it'll be all right.
He's so brave.
This is David Brinkley. We hope you've enjoyed the first half of the Julie Andrews Hour. And for a report on the second half, here is Chet Huntley, who has presently locked himself in the baggage compartment of a well-known commercial airline. Pathetic. While we try and free this poor devil, let's take time out now for a station break.
Popular motion pictures. Well, right now, there's absolutely no question as to the currently popular motion picture. And so here's Sid Ceasar with his version.
You. I know you will help me, Godpapa. I am sorry to bother you on this joyous day of your daughter's birthday, but I must. I am desperate.
Godpapa is sleeping. He's very tired.
But how can he sleep with his eyes open? Because...
You see, my old friend, I must always be on guard. Also, if you are sleeping and somebody shoot you, the bang from the gun wake you up, eh? What is the favor you would like?
Godpapa, my home is being bombed, my life is being threatened, and my family is being hurt.
My old friend, what can I do for you?
Please, Godpapa, stop bombing my home.
It's a very big favor, but for you,
we see.
Knock. Go outside and we join my daughter for her birthday party, eh?
Not yet, Godpapa. Your nephew Jimmy has come all the way from Hollywood to be with you.
Jimmy? 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 Hey, Jimmy, let me look. I don't know how long.
Hey, he come all the way from Hollywood, eh?
What's the matter?
You're hugging the weather.
You the waiter? Then wait. Excuse me. Now send in Jimmy. And this time, if it's not Jimmy, somebody's gonna have a tomato in his nose. Jimmy. Hey, you come all the way from Hollywood just to honor me on my daughter's birthday. Let me look at you. You Jimmy? You Jimmy? What's the matter? What can I do, eh?
I'm sorry to say that things aren't too good. The fact of the matter is, I need a favor.
For my favorite nephew, nothing is too good. What is the matter?
Well, you see, things haven't been going too well with my acting career, Godpapa, but I know I can make a big comeback if you can help me get the part that I've been waiting all my life to play. Mm. It's a big Broadway show, and it's the part of a band leader who's looking for that certain sound, that one sound. It's the life story of Count Basie. You just got to get it for me, Godfather. You just got to.
You see what we're going
to
do?
Wait, will you talk to the producer and ask him if I can get the part?
Jimmy, this Broadway producer.
Huh?
He lived in a house?
Oh, yes, Godfather, yes. As a matter of fact, he loves his house more than anything else in the world.
We're going to redecorate, huh? It's enough that he won't refuse.
Oh, you're a wonderful person, Godfather, just wonderful.
I drink to that, huh?
Oh, yes.
Salute. Delicious, huh?
Yeah, that's pretty good.
I make it myself. Everything's going to be all right.
I certainly appreciate
we're gonna
this,
take care of everything.
I really do.
No, don't worry.
All right,
everything's going to be
good.
Right.
We see you a little later.
Right. Take care now, Jim. Michael is here. Michael. Hey, Michael, I don't see you. I don't see how long. I don't even recognize you. I don't see you so long.
Godfather, you're hugging the band leader.
The band leader? Band leader. Excuse me.
Michael, come and say hello to your father.
Michael.
Oh, Daddy.
Oh, Michael. Oh, Michael, let me look at you. Michael, is this anywhere for a son of mine to dress, eh?
How many times do I have to tell you I'm a girl?
Hey. I'm going to tell you something right now. No son of mine is going to tell me he's a girl.
Don't pay any attention to him, Michael. He needs glasses, but he's too vain to get them.
Oh, why doesn't he wear contact lenses, Mama?
Because they don't make them bulletproof yet, huh? You take a picture, huh? That's good.
Big smile, everybody.
How's that? That's a camera? We see.
Okay, everybody, now big smile, please. One, two, three.
That's going to make a nice momentum, right? Now we have a nice time. You don't worry about music.
Oh.
Excuse me, Michael. Excuse me, Mama Rose.
Got bad news. Sammy went to the car wash and he emptied 5 machine guns into him.
Mm. I always told him, why go to a car wash? Wash your own car.
Daddy, 5 machine guns? Are you going to be all right?
Oh, don't worry, Michael. Lenny, get Dr. Minvini. He'll be all right. He may have a little stutter later, even when he's not talking.
Daddy, why?
Why? Come, Michael. I must talk with you alone. Business is business. Now you're my family. This is my business. Now, you see over here we got extortion. Over here, we got the numbers record.
away. You got beer, horse protection, bookmaking, gambling, blackmailing, broken arms, broken legs. Those are a few of my favorite things.
Daddy.
Like that song, yeah.
Daddy, how could you? You're nothing but a cheap, common gangster.
I call you the only one who talked like that to me. Because you're my son.
No, Daddy, I'm your daughter.
You're my son.
I'm your daughter.
That's your problem.
Daddy, how can you do it? I mean, blackmailing and killing and extortion and gambling and all those other things that are just not nice. I mean, what for, Daddy? Why? What for?
What for? For $8 million a week.
But why do you need $8 million a week?
Michael, you forget. Your mom, she don't work. I send you to college myself, eh?
But other people send their children to college.
Other people, they don't have sons who wear expensive dresses, eh?
Daddy, you've just got to give it all up.
I would, Michael. I would. I really would. But you see, Michael, there are families. They will start to move in. You see what happened to Sammy already, eh?
Oh.
Now they want out to get us. I think there's going to be trouble, Michael.
Oh.
Big trouble.
Well, when do you think this trouble is going to start?
Pretty soon.
Do you know your trouble? You're a slob. Every time there's a killing, I've got to clean up the mess.
Daddy, you've simply got to stop this senseless killing.
I'm good.
How?
I'm going to kill them.
Oh, no, Daddy, you mustn't do that. You mustn't, please.
Oh, don't do it, Papa.
Mama, you know the code.
Papa, please, don't do it.
Michael, I must. I must avenge the killing of my sons and the mess they made of your mother's house.
Papa, I'm begging you.
Mama,
no.
The god Papa has spoken, eh? Now I'll be right back. Don't you worry. Do you hear noise?
Yes, Papa.
Like a bang?
Yes.
Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. I'm all right. I'm all right. You were right, Mama. I was too vain, Michael. Too vain. I should have worn my glasses. What good that would have done, Mama.
He got those massage parlors. That's a new business. That massage. Thank you.
I'll see you soon, I know. No end.